Hey Coaster Enthusiasts, back here with another video, and today we're going to be reviewing Goliath at Six Flags Magic Mountain. This is one of only two geovanola hypers in the world, the other one being Titan at Six Flags over Texas. Now, this is a very fun ride, I think. The drop isn't steep, you get no airtime, but this ride definitely focuses on speed and laterals. Now, the lateral forces on this ride are insane. Definitely that last helix, the end helix on this ride. I mean, you will gray out. Now, there is one spot of airtime. There is a floater hill. Now, this floater hill, I got no airtime on. Maybe if I was in the back, I would have gotten airtime, but I would seriously doubt that. Though, after that, you're going to pop into your mid-course break run. Now, this mid-course break run is definitely a meme in the coaster community. It literally slows you down to nothing. Though Titan does this too, the only thing that's better about Titan is that you don't slow down before the helix. After the turnaround, you just go into the upward helix, and I think it's way more forceful. After you go down after the mid-course break run, you're going to do a few twists and turns and finally go into your downward helix. As I said, this downward helix is insane. So, if you're definitely at Magic Mountain, I would advise you going on this. And if you only have one day and it's a long line, don't. There's one at Six Flags Over Texas that is taller and better, I think. Though there is a fun thing I actually didn't know about this ride before I went on. There's a tunnel. I know that's kind of random, but it was fun. It was a fun tunnel. But definitely, it's not the best of hypers. I still haven't ridden a B&M hyper. Hopefully, I'll be able to go on one this summer. So, on that note, I would like to thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.